This is Dr. Pawluk. There is a huge amount of information available on the internet now about various kinds of pulsed magnetic field or PEMF therapy systems. Much of it is conflicting. Individuals, manufacturers, and professionals post opinions. Much of it is not scientifically accurate. Here are 8 of these lies that ignore the science. Many claim that high-intensity PEMFs are bad for you. These are usually from people who sell very low intensity systems under 5 Gauss. There is a large amount of research supporting the use of high intensity PEMFs for a vast range of problems. In fact, research looking at high intensity PEMFs to the brain in hundreds of thousands of people supports their safety as well, even in children. Number 2. On the other hand, there are others who claim that only high intensity PEMFs work. They also ignore a large amount of research demonstrating that lower intensity, medium strength PEMF fields between 10 and 1,000 Gauss are extraordinarily effective across a vast range of health problems. Number 3. Low intensity PEMFs aren't effective. While low intensity PEMFs under 1 Gauss or 500 microtesla have not been found to be very effective in research for specific health conditions, many people experience benefits. Very low intensity PEMFs may be most effective for health maintenance, for people with significant electrical or EMF sensitivity, or for improving circulation, among other benefits. Number 4. Some claim their PEMF system is the only one that improves circulation. All PEMFs improve circulation. Local stimulation, for example, the hand, will, by action on the nervous system, improve circulation throughout the whole body. Improved circulation is only one of the many benefits of PEMFs, often the least important. The body decides which particular action of a PEMF it will need to use most. All the various actions of the PEMF signal combined are needed to produce the best, most lasting, and most effective results. Number 5. Only certain waveforms are effective. While many devices use specific waveforms, the waveform is less likely important than the amount of charge it can induce in the body. Charge is responsible for most of the actions of PEMFs. Almost any waveform can be designed to maximize the amount of charge produced. Some waveforms may be more efficient for the best charge production, but this is not exclusive to any one waveform. Number 6. A specific frequency is the only one that works. A vast range of frequencies have been tested in research to treat a wide range of health conditions. Numerous frequencies have been found to be effective for similar conditions. There is no specific frequency that will solve all problems or help every health condition. Almost any frequency will help to some extent. In research, frequencies are usually not compared to others for the same problem. Number 7. You should only use earth-based frequencies. Several manufacturers claim their systems are more effective because they use earth-based frequencies. The fact is that the earth itself naturally has a vast range of frequencies. These include the so-called Schumann resonances ranging from 1 to 100 Hertz, those entering the polar regions from space, from natural materials, the rays of the sun, colors around us, and many others. Even the static magnetic field of the Earth varies, not only day to day, but also around the planet. 7.8 Hertz is not the only Schumann resonance. All the Schumann resonances are important and needed for optimal human functioning. Number 8. You only need to treat yourself for 8 minutes at a time. There is no evidence to support this claim. Studies have used many treatment times, most longer, with great benefit. The rule of thumb is that higher intensities need less time to achieve the best results. The practical limitations of research make it hard to know optimal treatment times in reality. Ultimately, the body being treated dictates the amount of treatment time necessary. Some medium intensity PEMF systems need up to 12 hours a day with no bad effects and with dramatic benefits. To read more about these studies or 20 other lies, exaggerations or inaccuracies about PEMFs, go to the link in this video post. Thank you, Dr. Pawluk.